Hello, so let's look at Rust. I've installed Rust cargo, the various Rust packages, and let me just bring up the sidebar. You can see the structure that Rust creates for you. It creates you a TOML file as well. And let's just go for Explorer. Got code runner, main. So this file's called main, sorry, this file's main.rs. So Rust files have the .rs extension. And then Code Runner actually compiles this for you. So if you just watch that, and it's run my code and it has compiled it. So if I delete that executable, move to trash, and you see there's no executable. So if I run this again, and you see it's made the executable. So and the Code Runner also fills that in for you. So if you look down here, that's quite a long, verbose version of it, which we don't need. So if I just do ls. So we've got main.rs, which is our source code, temp code runner.rs, which I don't really know what, I know what it does, but I don't know any more than that. So if we just run our executable, so this could have been written in, this is an exec a binary, so this could have been written in C, C++, whatever. There you go. It has run. And it has averaged three values. It said test passed, line 12. And what else has it done? I've told it to make an array. So line 16, I'm telling it to. So with Rust, it's done, sorry, statically typed as opposed to Python, which is dynamically typed. So when you create a variable, you should really be specifying what type it is. So you've got integers, which can be signed or unsigned. You've got floats, you've got characters, and you've got Boolean. A string is actually treated as a, or as a class. There's a class to handle strings, much like C, really. So yeah, Rust has got a lot in common with C. It's got bits in common with JavaScript, such as the, to be honest, well, the let, where in JavaScript it would be either let or var, wouldn't it? There is a thing that you need to do if you want to make the variable mutable. So you have to put in mut. Think if I put in mut, that should still compile. No, it doesn't. It's probably telling me that I don't need to make it mutatable. Yeah, there we go. The compile messages in Rust are much, I would say they're more user-friendly than they are with C. Obviously, with Python, you don't really, well, you don't get compile messages. You just get messages when you try and run it. So, yeah. We've got all our favorites here. We've got numeric variable. We're printing. So print ln. When you do print ln exclamation mark, the exclamation mark means it's running a macro, which again, it means it's not really a built-in command. It's going off and running some additional code, and what it's doing is it's printing the current line and it's putting a new line character in at the end. You don't have to do that, so you could just, for instance, on the last line, I needn't have done that. I could have just done print. So let's see what the error message is. Not a function. Okay. I thought I could get away without print. Does that work? Yes, it. Yeah, that worked. So again, that's a print macro, but it's, you don't need the ln. Yeah, so print ln instead of print. It's a lot of the syntax is similar to Python. This is it. The print here is similar to the old Python, the dot format convention before F strings. In an actual fact, I think as of the newer, let's just change that. I gather that as of the newer version of Rust, you can do that as well. And that's worked as well. So yeah, many, many Rust examples you will see if I undo that. So you see AV, that's my variable. And then you see the empty brackets. So basically the contents of that variable get inserted into these curly braces. So that's kind of, again, with Python and with Rust, that's the old way. So this is the new way. So I, what else could I do? I could also do that here, couldn't I? So run that. And have I got a typo? Test passed. Wow. Unclosed delimiter. Ah, I forgot the let's try again. Nope. Let's undo that then. And we'll run that again. Okay, what have we got here then? Oh, it's because I've got equals. Yeah, so when you're declaring a variable, should that be... colon? Let's go back, let's undo a bit, go back a bit. And sorry about that. Right, let's go back and run it again. And that's all working. So what did I, how did I break it? println, print. Put that back on the end, so that still compiles. So this goes in there. Oh, it's not. I think it's no longer evaluating because it's inside the quotes. Okay, so what you would need to do is create a variable and then update the variable and then put the variable inside here, just as the actual variable, not as so you. Actually say so the other thing you need to do is you need to say mut if you are modifying a variable as I tried to show up here earlier. So yeah, this is kind of a quick look at Rust. Again, I'm learning this pretty much from scratch, so yeah, that's just a very, very quick look at Rust. And just remember, it's compiled, and in most cases, you need to actually declare the variable types. And if it's an integer, then you either need to specify as a float, as an integer, as a signed integer, an unsigned integer. So obviously, a signed integer can be plus or minus. You can have U8, U16, U32, for instance, if you wanted an unsigned integer of 16. 16 bytes, you would do U16. So there we go. That's a quick look at Rust. Hope that's been interesting. If you've got any questions, then put them in the comments, subscribe and all that stuff. So thanks for watching.